Hi, I'm Stan Voynick, and welcome back to Ask an Expert, the web series where I talk about our thermal cameras and the technology behind them. Today I'm going to be talking about microbolometers, which are the sensors at the heart of our long-wave imaging systems. Let's go take a look in the lab. Now, a bolometer is an instrument, it's a scientific instrument, that measures incoming radiation, incoming light, by changing temperature. And so a bolometer could be a sizable object, a centimeter or more in size. If you took a bolometer outside and put it in sunlight, you could measure how intense the rays are from the sun, how much light, how much heat, how much energy is falling from sunlight. Now, a microbolometer, if we take that instrument, which could be a centimeter in size, shrink it down to say something like 10 microns, and then build an array of hundreds of thousands of those bolometers next to each other, that's when we call them microbolometers, because we've shrunk them down, and what's inside this sensor, the Tenem 640, is a microbolometer array. When we put a lens on the front of that sensor and we focus an incoming scene on that array of bolometers, and we bring those signals out and turn them into an infrared image. You know, I talked about there being thousands, tens of thousands of microbolometers in these sensor arrays. Let's talk actual numbers here. This is a Tenem 640, 640 pixels wide by 512 pixels high. There are 327,000 microbolometers in this array. Let's go up a level to the Tenem 1280, which is 1280 by 1024 pixels in size. That's about 1.3 million of those little 10 micron microbolometers in this sensor. And then this is the Athena sensor core. This is at the heart of our Vayu HD and Vayu HDI cameras. This is 1920 pixels wide by 1200 pixels high. And that's about 2.5 million of those microbolometers in that sensor array. Why the difference over such a wide range? Well, there are different applications for infrared imaging. There may be applications where size is most important, and with a smaller array, you can have smaller optics. On the other hand, there may be applications where you want a much wider field of view, and where you can afford to have a larger optic. And in that case, something like an Athena 1920 by 1200 would give you very wide field of view and very good resolution all at the same time. Thanks for joining us on this Ask an Expert video about microbolometers. I hope you found it informative and interesting. I encourage you to keep learning about IR technology through the videos in the other parts of our web series, midwave cameras, longwave cameras, and other subjects. If you have questions or comments, you can leave them down below. Thanks for watching.